Do you have a feeling on how far MT goes? Like, do you think that human level MT is realistic? Like, you know, it's funny when you talk about companies wanting like quality guarantees. I mean, I would think, just, you know, having used a lot of Google Translate in my life, you know, quality guarantees seem like would be useful, but also it just seems like the quality of Google Translate just isn't good enough that I would want to put that, you know, on my website generally. Like, do you expect that that is likely to change?
Yeah, I guess I can offer like some sort of assorted comments on thinking
Please.
About that.
Thank you.
In no particular order, because I think they're both technical and sort of social issues to do with that. And I think there's some like philosophical issues. So let's start with the philosophical issue. You know, translation is in this sort of space of so-called AI complete problems. So solving it would be equivalent to the advent of, you know, strong AI, if you will, because for any particular translation problem, world knowledge is required to solve the problem. And there are inputs that are not in the string that are required to produce a translation in another language.
Although, sorry to cut you off, but I guess it feels like, based on what I've seen lately from Google Translate, that it feels like less AI complete than I would have thought.
Yes. So that's the next comment that I'll make, which is that philosophical statement doesn't mean that within business settings, you should not be using it. And I'll give you an example. So one space we've been looking at recently is like crypto. Well, like 4 months ago, like nobody knew what a non-fungible token is. So like, how do you translate that into Swahili and Korean? Well, an MT system is not going to give you the answer to that question, because language is productive. People are making new words all the time. And mm-hmm. machines are not making up new words all the time. People are. And so philosophically, you've got to have training data for the system to be able to produce a result. People do not need training data to do that. So, but then I think increasingly there are a lot of business settings where it's good enough to solve the problem. So, you know, if you go for years, you can go to Airbnb and look at a flat and click translate with Google and it'll give you a translation. It may not be perfect, but it's certainly enough to convince you, you want to buy this, you know, rent this flat. And I think there will be more and more cases where fully automatic machine translation solves the business problem at hand. I think mm-hmm. that's absolutely true. And then I think there's a third part of it, which is sort of social and organizational, which is how soon, you know, VP of marketing, are you willing to let raw machine translation go on your landing page with no oversight?
Uh-huh.
And that's one way to think about that is like, how soon are you, Lucas, ready for a machine to respond to all of your email?
All of my own email.
Yeah.
Well, you know, I have to say,
some of it probably sure, but like others parts of it a little bit dangerous.
If you're enjoying Gradient Dissent, I'd really love for you to check out Fully Connected, which is an inclusive machine learning community that we're building to let everyone know about all the stuff going on in ML and all the new research coming out. If you go to wmb.ai/FC, you can see all the different stuff that we do, including Gradient Dissent, but also salons where we talk about new research and folks share insights, AMAs where you can directly connect with members of our community, and a Slack channel where you can get answers to everything from very basic questions about ML to bug reports on weights and biases to how to hire an ML team. We're looking forward to meeting you.